What's up, my people? My name is Spicy, and today we are reading Crazy Lady in the Base Exchange, Confused Guest, and finally, Earlier This Morning. Congratulations, Admiral Akbar, for the comment of the day, and everyone, leave a fire emoji in the comments if you think the video is fire. Crazy Lady in the Base Exchange. Oh my glob. After years of lurking on this site, getting indignant on others' behalf, chuckling and marveling at the audacity of some people, for the first time in my life, I have an Idont Work Here Lady story on my own, and it is a doozy. I am ex-military, and my husband, whom I met while serving, is still in. On most military bases, a company named APHIS has store which range in size and type, from small convenience shoppettes in gas stations to large department store style shops called base exchanges. NEX, PX, BX, MCX for short, depending on the branch of service of the particular base. Exchanges are tax-free and offer most merchandise at a discount from regular MSRP. The exchange nearest where we are stationed now is huge and has makeup counters, brand name clothing and shoes, and sells a lot of really, really expensive designer stuff at a huge discount. I tend to go in every once per month or so to get my makeup or for things like new shoes or work clothes. This afternoon, I decided to pop in on my lunch break and see if they had a particular size of hiking boot for an upcoming camping trip. And as I pretty much always do, I stopped to drool over the Prada and Louis Vuitton hands bag on sale, still way up in the thousands. I was in my business casual work clothes, beige slacks, white blouse, navy blue cardigan with my work logo suit on the left breast, and nude flats, which is fairly similar to the way the floor employees at the store dress. As I was looking, this very, very loud and interestingly dressed woman shouted,
"Excuse me, ma'am."
The ma'am part was extra emphasized, weirdly, so maybe she had been trying to get my attention before and I had not noticed? In any case, the tirade she unleashed when I turned around with a smile and said, "Yes?" was truly insane. She started out loud and proceeded to get louder and louder as she told me that she'd been trying to get someone to unlock the sunglasses case, which is the next department over, for hours. I'm doubtful about that. She asked me if I thought my time was more important than hers and steamrolled right over top of every sentence that came out of my mouth when I tried to interrupt her and let her know that I did not work there. For a few minutes, I just let her scream while I googled at her crazy outfit. Very, very bright neon top paired with electronic purple leggings, very unkempt looking hair, and grungy flip-flops. After a few moments, I just assumed that a person with a mental issue has wandered in, so I said, "Okay," and turned and started walking away. She screamed,
"Okay, okay,"
and I heard her start moving towards me at the same time as I saw an employee with a very visible black plastic name badge pinned to her shirt coming toward us quickly on the left. I turned around to face the crazy woman and stepped back immediately. The nut job was physically reaching out towards me as she was coming. She made a grab and the exchange employee got there and asked, "What is going on over here?" The nut job started ranting again and I calmly said to the employee, "I tried to tell her that I don't work here, but she seems pretty crazy." The crazy lady started screaming about me being rude and threatening to call the MP, the military police. I looked at the employee and said, "I am really sorry you have to deal with this psycho, but I've actually used up most of my lunch break and I need to go." The crazy lady started yelling, "Don't you let her go! I want to talk to your manager! She needs to be fired! This is discrimination!" The employee called for someone that sounded like Jared on her walkie and asked me to stay put. I'm sure she was as confused as I was and was not sure if I'd actively done something to the crazy lady or what. I stayed put. The employee asked crazy lady to please calm down and tell her what happened. And crazy lady quieted down a bit and began telling the employee loudly, but at least clearly and not screaming, that she had been trying to get my attention to unlock the sunglasses case. And then I ignored her, tried to talk over her, and then walked away. She was telling the employee about my terrible customer service and that I probably was not helping her because I was racist, when the employee very nicely said,
Ma'am, this woman does not work here."
Crazy lady actually shut up and looked completely gobsmacked. I said, "I was trying to tell you, but you will not let me say anything and you just kept yelling." Crazy lady looked at me and said,
"Well, you're still probably racist."
I said, "Okay, I really do have to go back to work now. and walked away. A manager caught me as I was leaving and offered me a nice 40% coupon and an apology. I took the coupon, but told her she did not owe me an apology. It is not her fault a crazy lady decided to go shopping today. Listen up everyone, we have an issue with crazy Karens all around the globe. We need your participation in order to stop Karens. I just had a conversation with multiple presidents across the world, and we all came up with one solution. I didn't know what to say, but they all pushed me to do it. They asked me to tell you to subscribe to the channel in order to stop Karens spreading across the globe. Don't listen to me, just listen to them. Some confused guest. To preface the story, I work at the front desk of a franchise hotel in a small town that has a restaurant in the same parking lot. Upstairs is fine dining, while the downstairs portion is more of a sports bar and grill. My shifts are 3 to 11. Not to brag, but I am head sales. And I usually take a lunch over at the restaurant because of convenience. Unfortunately for this day, we were slammed, so for more than half of my shift, I was non-stop checking people in and dealing with aggravated guests because I am all by myself and the person who is supposed to take over for me to take my lunch called in sick. I come to find out they just went to a party. So, I am looking forward to getting a time violation, because in California, you're not allowed to take a lunch a single minute after your fifth hour of working. However, I had no choice but to work through until my manager will come in instead of the other employee. Finally, my manager comes in, so I rush through my final check-in and clock out for lunch. Having that very heavy weight lifted off my shoulders, I walk as fast as I could to put my order in at the restaurant, since the hotel's business flows until the restaurant, so they are probably just as busy. Note, I am still in my fancy uniform with a name tag that has my name and my hotel's name. As I walked up to the bar portion of the restaurant, where they have very different kinds of uniform, they are more of a black button-up and jeans type of thing. Someone grabs my arm as to get my attention. Mind you, I am used to being mistaken as someone who works here, but it ends up being a, "Oh, sorry, I am with the hotel, not the bar," and I continue on with my day. But for a busy summer day or night in my area, no one is as nice as usual. Me to the arm grabber. "Sorry ma'am, but I am here for lunch." "Huh, that's funny, but will you be able to sit us down already? We've been here for 5 minutes already." "Again, I don't work here, but if you sit whenever is available, I can get someone to help you with an order." Her, visibly confused. "If you don't work here, then why do you have a name tag?" Now, I am a little confused because although it does have my name on it, it also says hotel name. "Ma'am, I work at the hotel across the lot and we are really busy. I need to put in an order before I am late." "Well, you're on the same property, so you work here too. So please, just seat us and get our drinks." "Even if I did work here, ma'am, I would not be able to wait on you considering I'm on lunch." She is now getting a little flustered because her son, around 8 or 10, is fuzzing around because he has to pee. So I point out where the bathroom is for him so he doesn't have to do the potty dance. "How can you not work here if you know where everything is?" "Oh, I work already, hotel, and I come here for lunch every night, so I know my way around. Please, just let me order and go back to it before I get in trouble." She just coughs and starts walking out of the bar without her son. I try to get her to at least wait for him, but she just ignores me and walks out and into her car, where all she does is sit there and stare at me like I am the bad guy. I decide that if I hurry up and put in my order, then wait for her kid to finish in the restroom, I could still probably make it back to the front desk before I am late back to work. The bathroom doesn't have too many stalls, so I figure he won't take too long. And I just wanna leave because I've been in a situation where I am in a strange place and can't find my mom, so I ended up waiting about 10 to 15 more minutes. I'm guessing it was a number 2. He eventually gets out and looks confused when he can't find his mother, so I walk up to him and explain that she's waiting in the car while walking him to the exit and point out where she was. All she said was, "Thanks," then peeled off. I ended up only being 2 or 3 minutes late, but at least the little guy found his mama. The restaurant was as busy as I figured, and since I am a regular, they did not finish my order until they knew they could give it to me hot and ready to eat. I'm not too happy that I had to wait even longer, but whatever, the food was amazing as always. Sorry for the story for being so long, but I wanted to remember most details so you could really feel like you're the one remembering it. Thank you for reading if you made it all the way through. And thank you for writing this beautiful story. Let me just go back a little bit. Both the mom and their son are in the restaurant, and obviously, they don't know where anything is. But she still decides to leave him alone in a bathroom at a place he knows nothing about? Man, that would have been really scary for that little guy. I remember as a kid, I would freak out if my mom was not inside when she told me she would be waiting for me. He had to figure out by himself to go out and find a car? Plus, it took like 15 minutes. What the hell was she thinking the whole time? Was she watching my YouTube videos or something? Maybe, but you're watching my videos right now, so better subscribe. Earlier this morning, some backstory. Monday, I received surgery to have a port catheter to put in for my infusions that I receive weekly. I was given a pain prescription that I was not able to fill until this morning around 9 a.m. Up until last night, I was tolerating the pain by taking Aleve. But around 9 p.m. the pain was so intense to ignore anymore. So I went first to my local ER. The nurse there said they are not allowed to do anything since I did not have the surgery there at that hospital since the surgeon was not affiliated with the hospital. So my husband drove me to the hospital that I did have the surgery performed at, and they admittedly took me in to see what was wrong. Come to find out that I am allergic to the transparent dressing that the surgeon put on the bandage to hold it in place. The nurse rebandaged my surgical wound and suggested items to purchase at the local Walmart to keep the wound dry and debris free. Now for the story. After being discharged, my husband drove us to the Walmart so I can purchase the items the nurse suggested. After getting the NextCare Gentle Paper Tape, non-stick pads, Equid Allergy Relief, and Ubrofen tablets, I was asked out right by someone that I never met before where something was. At this point in time, I was hurting and itching so much. I would admit I was very freaking rude to this person. Here's the conversation. Dumbfounded man. Can you help me find the box fans? I'm sorry, I don't work here. What is your name? It's me. What do you need to know that? No reason. Can you help me find the box fans? I already told you, I do not work here. I know, in fact, you work here. You are clearly wearing a blue shirt and tan pants. I am wearing a blue cami and tan capris and a hospital ER bracelet on my right wrist. My new bandage plainly on the left side of my chest, with pain and irritation on my face. Really? I don't work here, now go away. By that point, my husband walks around the corner and saves me from the dumb funny man. Ready to go home? Baby, you must be hurting really bad. Your forehead is sweating. Let's go. Since the pharmacy is closed, I would get the prescription filled at Walgreens. I don't feel good. Sorry it was not a flashy I don't work your lady moment, but I am finally not feeling any harsh pain. Just a dull ache. To the ones that are wondering where I actually work at, the answer is at Tyson Foods Processing Factory. The people that are in HR are wonderful and understanding, as well as my own supervisors and line lead. They all have been very supportive after I found out about my genetic disorder that I have. I am just curious to know why he wanted to know her name. It seemed weird to me. It happened to me before that people would ask for my name in public for no apparent reason, and I was like, yo, who are you and why do you need my name? I don't know why we are afraid to give out our names like it's our social security number or something. What a weird story, but I hope she's doing better now. I hope you enjoyed the heat you just received, and before you leave, thank you for liking the video, for commenting, for subscribing, and even for those who shares the videos. This really helped me a lot and I appreciate what you do for me. I wish you all a beautiful day. I hope you are doing your best to reach your dreams, live a fulfilled life, have fun, and love the people around you.